Whitestone Institute senior fellow and author of The Coming Collapse of China and the Great U.S.-China Tech War, Gordon Chang. He danced around that answer. It was China. This is espionage again from the Chinese. Yet there's John Kerry shaking hands and having dinners already in China to, of course, improve our relationship with that country. Gordon, your thoughts?
Yeah, there's so much wrong here. First of all, when we heard Jake Tapper and Jake Sullivan talk yesterday, Jake Sullivan talked about holding individuals accountable. Well, that's ridiculous. We have done that with regard to Chinese hackers in the past, and they just continue to hack. What we have to do is hold the Communist Party state accountable, and we have to impose costs that are greater than the Chinese are receiving in benefits. And, you know, what we're seeing is just ridiculous words, meaningless words out of the administration. You know, with regard to Kerry, this is the third straight American visit to Beijing without a return visit from a Chinese official. And this really is, I think, is going to just show that the Chinese believe that Americans are desperate to talk. And because we're desperate to talk, they're not going to make the concessions that Kerry wants. So this is not good diplomacy all around.
Well, in a first on Fox exclusive, former President Trump sat down with Maria on Sunday Morning Futures to discuss the China threat and the limits that he put on U.S. trade with Beijing while he was in office. Watch this exchange.
Would you be prepared to attack the economic relationship that we have with China? For example, the capital markets are wide open for communist China, and unwitting investors are basically funding the expansion of the CCP. Would you put limits in place in terms of what Americans can buy?
So I did something better. I did tremendous tariffs. We took in hundreds of billions of dollars, tariffs and taxes. So when China, which was just dumping everything into our country, steel and everything. You know, they were dumping steel at a level that was going to put our steel mills out of business, which is what they wanted. I saved the steel industry. We were dead. And I taxed a 50% tax on dumping steel. And then they start sending it through other countries, and we caught them, and they start sending it through Canada.
So, Gordon, have we economically given the Chinese a free pass under President Biden?
Well, we certainly have. And really, those tariffs need to be higher. You know, President Trump's tariffs were a landmark. They changed the way the United States thought about China, and they actually started to impose costs on China. Those costs should have been higher. They should certainly be higher still, because we see the Chinese engaging in this predatory behavior and continuing to steal our intellectual property. So really, all around, we need a much firmer response. The Biden administration is not doing that, and at some point, they're going to have to change, because the American people demand what President Trump did, and I think they actually demand tougher action out of the administration than we saw in the past.
Well, you know what, Gordon, you and I were talking about this last week, because about, you know, what the next president, whether it's Biden or whether it's Donald Trump or it's Christie or Tim Scott, what that president could do to deal with China. How do you put a, you know, how do you start to handle China to make sure that they stop stealing IP, to take advantage of us on the world stage, and to, you know, to work with the Russians, et cetera, et cetera. You said that the 1977 Commerce Act, and you know the title better than I do, is a way that we could actually say to American companies, flat out, enough of investing in China, enough of dealing with, let's call him a dictator, Xi Jinping.
Yes. Well, it's the International Emergency Economic Powers Act of 1977 that gives the president of the United States enormous executive power to sever relations with China, which is what we need to do, because that's the only thing that is going to get China's attention. And if we don't want to use the 77 Act, then we should declare China to be an enemy and use the 1917 Act, which is even tougher. Really, what we've got here, though, is a failure of political will in the United States. The Chinese continue a course of action, which is not only intellectual property theft, but predatory trade actions, violating their trade obligations to the United States. And, you know, here we have Jake Sullivan just say, oh, well, you know, maybe we'll prosecute some individuals who will never see the inside of a federal court. This really is wrong all around. And until that, we are not protecting American workers. Yes, some people on Wall Street are doing very well. Walmart is doing very well. But when you look at the overall American economy, there are so many Americans who could be employed or could be employed in better jobs were it not for China's economic warfare against the United States.
Yeah, Mike Lee and I were just talking about that before this segment. Gordon Chang, it's good to see you this morning. Thank you.
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MACAD TV family. Please like and share MACAD TV. We love you all. Please support MACAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.